It's difficult for me to describe how I feel because I feel so grateful and so lucky. We made a discovery even better than what I was expecting. This is a real discovery that will change, I'm sure, our view on life events.
We want to understand how animals travel, how they disperse. We look for the first time into the subsurface life. Animals are able to live below hydrothermal vents, and this is, I think, mind-blowing. Now we know that, for example, dew bombs, they can colonize vents by traveling through the subsurface. This is the first finding. We know that these dew bombs, they can live in this cave system. That's the second finding. And the third finding is that also the mobile fauna, mobile vent fauna, can live in these subsurface areas.
The beauty of all of this is also that the experiment itself was not even working so well.
We kind of needed to be creative and, you know, apply basically a new method. Flipping around the rocks opened our view into the underworld of hydrothermal vents.
Oh, whoa. Whoa.
That was a power move right there.
What we found was that we found even animals living below the surface. And this is basically subsurface vents that this can be potentially quite extensive.
So look at that, there's a tube worm, a little tube here. They're everywhere. It's our proof, basically.
Yes.
And when you see researchers that really like spend their whole life studying this system, and that they are like so happy because they still discover something new, this was like wow, goosebumps. Oceans constitute 70% of Earth surface and more than 90% of Earth biosphere. By understanding all these small parts of the ocean, we can then see the bigger picture.
And for many of these species, we know so little right now, and getting that information to understand how climate change and how deep sea mining and other potential human and commercial interests can affect these communities is really important.
With this understanding, we also know that we not only need to protect what we see on the surface, but also we should protect what is living below, because it is one important component of this ecosystem.
You look out over the ocean, it does seem like this like vast emptiness. And then it's awesome to just like sit and watch the ROV feed as they're coming up and see like that there's actually so much life there.
I'm surprised. I thought it will not be so diverse. Basically, every dive we go up and down, there are new things. I mean, it's all exciting at the seafloor, but then we also have this kind of a, you know, like movie. Like
I'm at the end of my career. Really, I have only a few years left. I always wish that I could be chief scientist on one ship for one time. And this wish was granted basically by Schmidt Ocean Institute. That idea that sounds very crazy can be confirmed. I mean, this is for a scientist. There's nothing better than this, you know? And I'm also very grateful that I could do this on this ship, and especially with the crew of the ship.
All the ROV pilots, the marine technicians, the crew, everyone on board here is essential for this discovery, to be very clear. Like, you cannot do it alone.